been on my mind. Sick and tired of the 9 to 5 in the city light. Hey, darling, we could get out of town. See the beautiful world around, wanna see it now. And get in that car. Leave a little note and we'll drive real far. Hey guys, I'm here at Walmart to pick up a very massive grocery order. I think it was $1,622 deep in groceries. I was trying to kind of stock up our freezer. I was also trying to stock up the pantry. And then we have sick kids, so I was trying to make sure we have pudding and Jell-O and yogurt and things like that that the kids will, you know, eat if they don't feel like eating food. And so, you know, it ended up quickly growing, and then I would remember something and forget something and remember something and so on. And I kept adding things to the order. And upon getting here, I realized that I still forgot ginger, but I'm not going in the store for it. But it ended up being $1,622 worth of groceries. So I'll show you guys everything. There was a few items that are actually being shipped, so they'll be coming, you know, obviously by delivery, but most of the items are in my pickup order. I just have a few of the Jordan skinny syrups coming, and I don't remember what else is coming via shipping, but it was just like 3 items were being shipped. Other than that, $1,622 is what I spent to hopefully fill our freezer, fill our pantry, take care of sick people, and get everybody on the mend, and get us to where I don't have to grocery shop while trying to get things unpacked, because my porch is piled with stuff that needs to be unpacked. And I have made it my goal that nothing comes in the house unless I've gone through it, because my kids just have so much stuff, and they will refuse to get rid of things that are broken and torn up, and I just don't want to do that. So I just flat out told them, I will go through everything, I will bring everything in the house, and then you can put it away. So I'm individually going through each box or bag or container or tote or whatever, and I'm sorting things out and bagging up things to go in the trash or to be donated. And then what the kids are keeping will go in the house. But it's just the only way that I know of that things will get sorted out and get downsized and save us from having a complete chaos zone, because my girls especially just have too much of too much. And CJ has too many clothes for a kid who only wears like 4 different things. And like, we need to downsize. And so I've really got to work on that before the weather, like, you know, rains and stuff, because all of that stuff's piled on the porch. And if the rain and wind blow, you know, stuff could get wet and get moldy. So I've got to get busy on that. So I've tried to make sure that our freezer is very well stocked. That's definitely my order. Very well stocked with enough stuff to get us by for a while, and that we won't have to worry about anything. So, nope, that one's not mine either. Apparently everybody is doing their giant grocery trips today. That's the second one I've seen where there is at least like 16 baskets stacked up on their cart. But anyways, I wanted to make sure that I have things that I can pull from and just get meals together, get meals in the oven, in the crock pot, on the stove, whatever. Oh, that's definitely me. That's mine. I know that is. Okay, friends, so we're going to jump right into this. We have 2 table loads that I'm going to show you. So here's the first table load. We're going to go through. I'll show you everything I picked up, if it's a stock up item or not. I got some yogurt for all my sick kids, so I've got a 12-pack, and then I also got a big tub for smoothies. I got some Jell-Os for the kids. Again, everybody has the flu. Some flour, sugar, self-rising flour. Over here, I've got a bunch of oil. That's just a stock-up item. Sugar-free creamer, because I'm going to try to do a lot better on my coffees. Whipping cream for cooking, another sugar-free creamer. I do not like to run out of coffee creamer. I've got some grilled chicken and some seasoned fries, a turkey breast to throw in the slow cooker, and then I got three of these bacon wrapped turkey that I like to have James put on the smoker, and we eat those with just a few simple sides. 4 cans of peas and carrots, 6 cans of corn. I got 6 of the white cake mixes. Those are just stock up type items to have on hand. I got a Caesar salad mix and 3 heads of romaine lettuce for just various things. Dark brown sugar and powdered sugar for baking, some pineapple for snacking, a bunch of tomatoes for burgers and salads and tomato sandwiches. And then we're going to come around over here. I got a whole bunch of Jell-Os and puddings. I was just putting them in my cart, and I didn't realize until I got them home and was lining them up on the table how many we ended up with. But these are a good stock up item to have. They make a simple summer dessert. We can use them to make poke cakes. We'll have them on hand if kids get sick. So any which way you look at it, this is a good item to have on hand. But I definitely have a bunch and a interesting variety here. I'm trying to get back on my wagon with eating healthier. So I got myself 2 things of Chobani yogurt. We got sour cream, baking powder, some Reese's chips and the Ghirardelli chips. Some of this honey roasted peanut butter. The kids are liking that right now. And then a big peanut butter just because that kind's cheaper. And then I got coffee, liquid aminos, 2 of the soy sauces. I did not order this big soy sauce, but it's here. So there you go. And then I got 7 sugar-free whipped creams to use for different desserts and things. 2 grape juices because stomach sickness is going on. Got myself 2 of the ISO shake mixes. I drink those a lot in the morning since I am not good about eating breakfast. So I got myself some of those just to make sure I have something in the mornings. And then over here, I've got some wild blueberry muffin mix and a different one. The Betty Crocker was a substitute. And then I got Duke's Mayo and a Miracle Whip stock up items. We actually don't need those, but I thought we better have them extras in the pantry. Tartar sauces and a cocktail sauce. And then I have a variety of different muffin mixes because the girls sometimes like to make quick breakfast. And these are just easy for them to throw in the oven and have quick muffins. I grabbed a chuck roast to throw in the slow cooker one day for an easy dinner. 2 rolls of hamburger meat we're going to divide up. And then I've got some chicken breast here that'll make 3 packages of meat for the freezer. Another 3 packages of meat will come out of this package of chicken breast. And then the thighs, I'll divide this one into 2 and we'll have 2 different meals with that because I don't use as much when I do soups and things. And then we'll leave 1 whole for when we bake chicken thighs for dinner. But if we're going to do soup, I can get away with just using 4. And then the same with these chicken thighs. Some will get divided up, some will be left whole. I just really wanted to stock up and test the limits of the new freezer. And then I got, again, I'm back on my diet plan. So I got myself a variety of skinny girl salad dressings because I'm trying really hard to watch my calorie intake. And then I got myself some light mayo. Got the kids some more ranch dressing. We only have 1 left in the pantry, so that's a stock up item. Prego spaghetti sauce, 2 whole chickens. Better than bouillon chicken and beef. I just always grab these every single time I get groceries because I use them to make gravies, I throw them in soups, all that. And then got James 4 cans of ranch beans. He likes to eat ranch beans several times a week. And then I got a hole punch and a bunch of these little rings that we're going to use on our spelling words so that the kids can keep track of those. Okay, deep breath. We're going to jump into the next table load of stuff. I've got 2 things of biscuits. Got myself some of these low-carb tortillas because we have plenty of regular, but I'm out of my low-carb ones, and they are lower calorie. Crinkle-cut fries for the freezer. I got 3 things of carrot chips. Me and Bubba eat tons of those. Got 2 apple sauces for snacking, some sweet and sour, some oyster sauce. I'm going to make Chinese food at home soon. Got some honey for anybody that wants honey in their tea or whatever. And then I got James this Welch's. It's the natural jelly. Sometimes he'll eat it, sometimes he won't, but I went ahead and grabbed that for him. Grabbed some Splenda monk fruit. I'm going to give that a try in my coffee and in some of our baking and see how we like it. Graham crackers, got some Greek yogurt so I can make a big thing of Greek yogurt again. I got tortilla chips and 2 things of animal crackers. And then over here, shrimp spring rolls. Some Cheddar Bay biscuit cod. We've never had this, but hopefully it's good. We're going to make it for lunch one day for the kids and I.
And then I got some chicken egg rolls. These were a substitution. I actually ordered pork, but they gave us chicken. No big deal, really. Shrimp scampi, just to throw on the side of a dinner for those that like shrimp. And then I got Colby Jack cheese. Two things of pork tenderloins. That's one of the kids' favorite dinners. And then I showed you the Greek yogurt already. Okay, so I've got pork loins. I'm going to slice some of these up for big, thick cut boneless pork chops. And then probably put one in the freezer whole for pulled pork sandwiches or to smoke. And then I got four packages of these chicken drumsticks. I will put the whole thing like this in the freezer because they will eat the whole thing if we smoke or bake drumsticks. And those are super cheap. And then I got a variety of fish here. I have whiting. And then I got another of the just for a variety of fish. The kids and I eat fish a lot for lunch. And then two packages of chicken wings so we can do wings one night. A chicken leg quarters. It's 10 pounds. We'll throw that on the smoker. And then I got a thing of shrimp with cocktail sauce. And then I have some raw shrimp and a few things of cooked shrimp. Just because the cooked shrimp is a good like snack while we do schoolwork. The raw shrimp I can use for fajitas or tacos or something like that for the kids and I. I got 2 gallons of milk here. These are, one is going to be for yogurt and one is going to be for drinking. I got 3 things of sausage patties for a quick breakfast, and it's a stock up item I can keep in the freezer. I got 6 things of green beans, and then I've got some white bread and some wheat bread that is keto, and that's for me. 20 bananas, and then over here I got hamburger buns. And then I got oranges, cabbage, I got red grapes, green grapes, some scallions for when I make egg drop soup, ground turkey with no real plan. I just thought if we had it in the freezer, it's a healthier option than ground beef. Got some smoked turkey wings that I'm going to use in the cabbage, some more skinny girl dressing, some caramel for my coffee, and then we've got 4 things of fried mushrooms and then a case of 12 cans of chicken noodle soup. And then over here, I've got a variety of different lunch meats. This one, if it'll focus, hold on a second, I'm going to get it to focus here. But this is Black Forest ham. And then I've got, this one is salami. Let's see if you guys can see all these. And then we have right here, a medium roast beef. This one is a Cajun turkey. That's James's favorite. And then this one here is a garlic herb chicken. So we have a variety of different lunch meats. We have some celery, some cheese for having sandwiches, some mozzarella's for a baked ravioli dinner, some Italian sausage. We have 2 packages of ribeyes, which will be a good charcoaled steak night dinner for everybody. And then more chicken, guys. So I'm going to divide this one up into probably 2 or 3 packages of chicken. And then we have more wings. It'll take all 3 packages of wings to make 1 chicken wing dinner for everybody. Maybe even 4 if we have company over. So I got a bunch of wings. And then over here, this one is thighs. I'll leave this one probably whole and just throw it in the freezer like that. Now, here is an overview of our pantry after everything has been put away. This is where we stand with our food supply. And that box on the ground is a large tub of lard that I need to jar up. Now, here is our freezer status. As you can see, it is pretty full. And this is a giant freezer. It's about 7 foot tall. So here is the door. Again, it's full of all kinds of goodies. We have our yogurts and our granolas in here, wontons, raviolis, all that stuff in the door. Now here's our bread, here's our fruit, potatoes, onions, cereal, and then here is what our fridge looks like. I have some of the chicken and stuff in here as I'm bagging it up to put in the freezer and the vacuum sealing it. I'm moving it, but this way it stays nice and cool in the fridge while I work on it. It's just, I don't know, it's easier that way, and I know that the food is staying cold. Here is our freezer at the bottom of the fridge, and I have a bunch of stuff in here. And there is also a pull-out tray. Let me show you guys. Right there. And it has ice cream, including a kid's ice cream they didn't finish. And Pedia Pops and 1 thing of sausage in there. So that is kind of the status of our refrigerator. Here is the other side. It's just all of our condiments and things like that. And yeah, so that is everything. Thank you guys so much for watching this grocery haul and pantry video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you next time with another new video. Bye.